It's about that Sony. It's about that Sony since day one. It's time, baby. It's time. It's time, baby. We got 1 minute. 1 minute. We don't care. It's that time, baby. It's that time. It's that time, baby. It's that time, baby. It's that time. We don't care about that Nintendo anymore. It's all about Sony. It's all about Sony. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Oh, I'm nervous. I'm nervous, bro.
Sony apparently said it's recommended to use headphones, so in doing it...
I'm using my headphones too. I got my headphones on right now. It's time, boys. 1 minute left, baby. 1 minute left, baby. Put that volume up. Put that volume up. I'm mute. I'm pausing donations and notifications right now. It's paused. So if you guys are trying to send me something now, it's too late. It's all about Sony. Sony always wins, baby. Come on, do not disappoint, please. Please do not disappoint. Do not disappoint. Oh God, I'm getting nervous. Oh God. How's the volume, guys? Everything sounds good. Everything looks good. Everything looks good. Everything sounds good. Oh, baby, it's time. It's time. Sony always wins, baby. Sony always wins, baby. Sony always wins, baby. Sony always wins, baby. Let's go. Oh, my gosh. Any cucumbers? There better not be no cucumbers in my chat. Is Nintendo Ultra in here? Nah, Ultra's probably streaming it himself. My man, Ultra. Yo, who's online? Is Ultra online? Who else is online? Everybody else is online? Nintendo Ultra? Yo. Put some respect on my boy Ultra. It's time! It's time! Let's go, baby. Let's go. Oh, we getting trailers, baby. We getting trailers, baby. I don't know why I thought the console was shaped like a square. I mean, I said a square, it's a triangle. I'm so nervous. I'm nervous for them. I'm so nervous, and it's not even me presenting anything. Oh my gosh. Oh man. He says shapes. Let's go. Shapes. Let's go. The sounds are enhanced with headphones. I hear it. I hear it. It sounds crazy.
Choices, how we might have ended up.
No, I like the hand we've been dealt.
Whoa, we got that. We got God of War. We got the, oh my God. Uncharted. We got Killzone. We got Knack. We got, oh my God. Little Big Planet. We got Final Fantasy, baby. We got Persona. Oh, I'm getting hype. I'm getting hype. I'm getting hype. I'm getting...
You, me, together, we were destined for something great.
Ratchet and Clank, baby. We got freaking Gravity Rush.
Why did I move here?
We got another Rockstar game, baby.
Or the, I don't know, that thing, that magic.
We got more Grand Theft Auto 5 content.
Get out of this bullshit.
You sounding more and more like a snee-eye itch every day.
My job, my score, get your own.
I'm gonna be real with you, chat.
We should talk.
Chat, I've never played GTA 5. I've never played this game.
We out here gang banging like it's 91.
We all love banks.
Get me a DJ.
Give me a hand with these bodies.
This cannot be traced back to me.
Champagne, anyone?
Just sort of smash things.
The cars just started flying.
So now what?
So, this game never dies. This game, GTA never dies, bro. What? You get $1 million in the game every month? What?
It was great to kick today off with a look back at just some of the seminal moments of the last 25 years. And what better way to bridge our past and our future than with a game that's graced every PlayStation console, Grand Theft Auto. It's been a privilege partnering with Rockstar Games for many years now, and we're thrilled to open today with the news that that partnership will continue with PlayStation 5. It's now just over a year since we began sharing technical details of PlayStation 5, but today's the day that we've been looking forward to for years, when we get to show you just some of the games that demonstrate our belief that PlayStation 5 marks the biggest generational transition our industry has yet seen. The content we've curated for today's event showcases how PS5 has inspired developers to create new experiences that are transformative in how they look, sound, and feel. Enough from me. We're gonna have the games do our talking.
Every game shown this point forward is from PlayStation 5.
A hero is just someone who doesn't give up.
Is this Infamous?
Your dad said that. He was
Spider-Man?
Right.
That's Spider-Man!
Now it's your turn. Go be a hero, Miles.
Okay, let's do this.
Oh my god! Bro, I gotta play this Spider-Man game. This shit looks fire! You could be Black Spider-Man, bro! Bro, this is fire!
今日は皆さんに僕らが作っている新しいグランツーリスモの情報をシェアできるということで、すごく興奮しています。今回のグランツーリスモは、今回のグランツーリスモは、これまでのグランツーリスモのファンの方がプレイしたら本当に嬉しいんじゃないかなっていう、キャンペーンモードを中心にしたグランツーリスモになっていると思います。ぜひ楽しみにしていてください。
Gran Turismo Bime? Who buys Gran Turismo games? Like, honestly asking. Driving simulator. That, I mean, some people got their kinks. Some people like this shit. Realistic as hell, but I'm gonna be real with you, racing games like this are, is that the bat? I thought that was the Batmobile in front of him. I'm about to say, wait, what the hell? The sounds, bro. You got your headphones on, bro? You got your headphones on? Yo, this just sounds crazy. The sounds, bro. Yo, it sounds really good. I mean, it looks great. It sounds great. Yo. You said that was 100% an eargasm. That just sounded nice. It felt like I was inside that car. Are collapsing on one. Oh no! Get to, oh, I'm a fucking cry. Right. Oh shit! We can't be that far. They got Dr. Nefarious and Captain Quark in this bitch. They have found us, Ratchet. Yo, they got another Ratchet and Clank game in the works.
How do I steer this thing?
Oh my! Nicely. I feel like a fucking kid. Oh shit! They got the boy Ratchet and Clank on the grinding gears! Oh my god.
How bad is it?
Where is he going?
Well, it is certainly not good.
Great!
Yo, bro, Sony always wins, baby! Yo, Ratchet and Clank! Yo! I'm so hype right now! Bro. You telling me Ratchet and Clank, they're separated in different portions of the world? And this world is ruled by Dr. Nefarious! Bitch Ratchet! There's a girl Ratchet!
Marcus Smith, creative director at Insomniac Games. The entire studio is so excited to be able to share with you a first ever look at Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart.
Insomniac Gaming!
Full length interdimensional adventure built from the ground up for the PlayStation 5. We're doing things we've never been able to do before, like use dimensional rifts to be able to leap from planet to planet nearly instantly, or put ray trace reflections on Clank.
All they put ray tracing. I noticed that on Clank was super shiny.
Plus, Ratchet's all-new arsenal is more exciting than ever thanks to the DualSense controller's enhanced feedback. Ratchet and Clank are near and dear to our hearts at Insomniac.
Yes!
We can't wait to share more with you in the future. But for now, here's another look.
Another look, thank you! I want to look more at this. Yo, Ratchet and Clank, baby!
Did you see that?
What?
It's Ratchet and Clank.
This is so fire!
From above.
He's still got the same 1-2 combo. The jump to the he got the same shit.
Nice and sharp.
Oh, he can still throw the freaking oh my god.
Was that a Kraken? Or at least a very large octopus.
Yo, where's Captain Quark? Where's Dr. Nefarious? This is pre-alpha footage. It shows it at the bottom. You guys just can't see it. Pre-alpha. Where's the weapon level ups?
Did Dr. Nefarious really resurface after all these years just to try... and take over the
nice.
Yeah. I kind of wish he was.
Where's the chicken ray? Where is the chicken ray?
That's what I'm afraid of.
What is that effect? That, like, that's tripping me out every time. Oh, it's like a shotgun. The gun's about to level up. The gun's about to level up.
That's all of them.
Rift apart. Ratchet and Clank rift apart. Oh, I'm so happy right now, bro. I feel like a little kid. Bro, they really brought back Ratchet and Clank. Oh my god, my heart. Oh, Sony always wins, baby. Oh my god. Oh, they really brought back Ratchet and Clank. Holy shit. Square Enix, okay. Okay, Square, what do you guys got? What the heck? Was that the girl from the demo? Project Athia? Designed exclusively for the PlayStation 5. Ooh. Yo, that dragon was kind of leaking. He was kind of leaking on his chest. He gotta get that fixed. I'm so sorry, chat. I was screaming into that mic. Ratchet and Clank got me too hype. Black Cat. The cat got a backpack on. Cat the video game? I get to play as a cat? Stray the video? It's a cat simulator, chat. Hey, if that shit got a platinum trophy, I'm a platinum that bitch. Hey, hopefully we get some more footage of that cat game soon, alright? Neon Stranding? Oh my gosh. ...4K Ultra HD Blu-ray. Ultra High Speed Super Sexy Drive. Ray Tracing. That controller is sexy, bro. Haptic Feedback. That controller is sexy. Adaptive triggers. USB Type-C! USB Type-C, baby! Built-in microphone, headset jack. We still got the headphone jack. Let's go! 3D audio. Okay.
Making games used to be about these constant trade-offs between the artistic vision and technical limitations. With PS5, we're not going to be burdened like that. We're going to be able to realize our artistic vision a lot better. It's got a ton of horsepower, which is very easy to unlock, and it's a machine that's really easy to develop on. The PS5 will present a paradigm shift as to what players will come to expect from gaming. Will let us tell stories, make worlds, great gameplay that I think will truly captivate the player and really surprise quite a few people. Please take a look at this new franchise for Worldwide Studios coming exclusively for PlayStation 5.
Everyone in the chat is so pissed. They're like, I want to see the console. Bro, to be honest, man, if they keep showing sexy ass games, yo, I feel like yo, if they don't show it in this one, that's gonna be a big ass manga S if they don't show it. They're gonna show it. They just kinda leading up to it. That's what I feel. I feel like they're trying to just keep sprinkling shit to make you build up to it. They don't wanna, cause if they show it straight out in the beginning, I feel like it's just gonna be like, okay, that's it.
Each time I awake, this planet seems somehow different, as if changing. This world is becoming part of me.
Don't touch that shit. Why would you touch that?
Affecting my mind, my memories.
That's Thanos' house!
The longer I
She was going to Thanos' house!
The more I can feel my sanity slip away. But I cannot lose hope. My only choice is to keep fighting. To keep looking for answers. My only hope is to break the cycle. to me.
That game looks very interesting. Very interesting. Sumo Digital. What the fuck is this? Don't tell me it's another Little Big Planet game. Weren't those the guys that worked on Little Big Planet? It's Little Big Planet! Bro! Oh my god, no! But I don't want it to be worked on by Sumo Digital! Wait a minute, hold on. I can't judge it just yet. Wait. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. It's looking good. Please just let it be Sackboys. Just let it be Sackboys. Don't let it have the other shit. Just let it be the Sackboys. Sackboy, Sackgirl. Just keep it as them. It doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bad. So it's called Sackboy, A Big Adventure. It doesn't look bad. It doesn't look bad. So it's not called Little Big Planet. Sackboy, A Big Adventure. It kind of gave me Minecraft Dungeons kind of feel. It doesn't look bad. I have to see more gameplay of it. But the reason why I'm a little nervous is because Sumo Digital, I think, was the same company that made Little Big Planet 3. And Little Big Planet 3 was trash, bro. It was trash. So, hopefully, Sumo Digital, they could redeem themselves in this new game. I want to be the cute anime girl, chat. If you pick her, we're going to fight. What is this game? It looks cool. Rocket League? Is this like a new Rocket League? No, Destruction All-Stars. It looks cool. I think it looks really cool. You said Zoomer game? My interest has been piqued. Damn, but that Little Big Planet game, I gotta relook at that trailer after it. The trailer, like...
Hello, everyone. My name is Josh Greer.
What threw me off on that Little Big Planet was literally the word Sumo Digital. I was like, animation. Oh, God.
And we're very excited today to share with you the first look at our new game.
Fuck, Sumo Digital, please don't mess this up. The game looks good. It has themes of personal growth
and redemption. So please enjoy.
Oh, Oh, this game looks so cute. Look at their feet. Oh, they're so cute.
I know you are kind. You sense the power that flows through this land. Yet, you do not fully understand it. Driven by the belief that you
this
can
game looking fire, bro.
Troubled spirits. But you cannot hide your weakness from me.
This game looks kind of fire.
You have no power here.
Show us gameplay. Yes, show us gameplay. Show us gameplay. This game looks cute as hell. What is this, PlayStation Pikmin? Dude, this game looks fire. What's this game called? Kena? Bridges of Spirits. Okay, this game has piqued my interest. This game looks pretty good. Well, I got like 20 notifications on my phone. Did everybody go on live at the same time and I'm finally getting the notifications now?
You ever feel like you're just waiting for a sign?
Anime?
To do that thing you've always meant to do.
Uh-oh. This looks like some Tumblr shit. This
Sometimes
looks like
I
some
feel
Tumblr
like
shit.
On the edge of doing great things.
This is some Tumblr shit.
Something's holding you back.
Oh
Maybe it's
god.
Just nerves. Maybe it's the fear that I'll never be as good as
this
what
game imagine. Looks like it's made for people that cancel that loves cancel culture.
But if we've got nothing else to lose, might as well jump.
I know what type of game this is. I'm not gonna say what type of game this is, but I know what type of game this is. And I feel like everyone in the chat knows what type of game this is.
Hi, I'm Lauren Lanning, and I'm here to share with you a game that I've been dying to make. It's an emotionally engaging story where rescuing is rewarding, failure is devastatingly hilarious, and the memories should last you a lifetime. Take a look.
I feel like the game story might be like crazy good and a lot of people are still gonna play it though. What are its game's trophies looking like though? Are the trophies easy or are the trophies hella hard?
They believed, trusted, followed, and it led them here.
Squidward?
You may have escaped the murderous blades. For the fate of your entire people.
This game looks familiar.
Is up to you.
Holy Why is this trailer so serious?
You must find your full voice.
This game looks super serious. I mean, if the game got some easy trophies, I don't mind playing it.
我々の考える東京のビジュアルを実現できました。
PlayStation。
今までに見たことのない東京の魅力を見て、
聞いて、
感じることができます。
Charm of Tokyo。
これからお見せするのは、
What game is this?
Ghostwire Tokyo の世界初のゲームプレイ。
Ghostwire's Tokyo gameplay。
スーパーナチュラルでミステリアスな東京、そこに潜む脅威と美しさを感じ取っていただけると思います。
Supernatural Tokyo。
ぜひお楽しみください。
Tokyo, Japan.
You see things others can't. Hear threats others don't.
We going into mementos?
Fight. When others won't. It's up to you to save Tokyo.
What? This looks nuts! This game looks like a trip! This game looks trippy. And it looks scary, and I feel like the chat wants me to play that shit because they know I'm gonna get scared. Is this Nier Automata? I thought it was gonna be some Nier Automata shit. People. What the heck is that? For a people? Carve out the future for a people? You say Elon Musk, the video game. This is where Elon Musk's child was born. Oh, God. AEX-12, oh shit. This game is making me uncomfortable. Like, look how tiny we are and how far away the camera is. And then it's like, I feel like I'll die to anything. This looks like the type of game that rain will kill you. It'd be like it's raining, and then your health is falling lower while like you're getting pelted by fucking raindrops. Gearbox. What game is this? Make way for the king of kings for a long stretch, no limousine. If you talk on one, it's gotta intervene. I'm the biggest one of those you ever seen. I'ma need a crown. I'm the only one that ever held it down at the tip top. People flip flop every day, not I top five. I'm a big shot. I'm the one that wanna take the big shots. Big balls, big rings, big rocks, big bag, big moves, big cars, big man, big plan. Get lost in this world. Look at me now, count me down. So give me the crown, mate. Wait for the king. We're not the same. We're not the same. We're not the same. We run everything. We're not the same. You said the music's trash. The music ain't trash. Yo, Ice Ghost, let me time this man out again. Oh, I timed out the wrong man. Nah, hold up. Somebody recover him. We gotta kill Ice Ghost. And because I missed the shot, 10 minutes. Yo, somebody recover that man. Bring him back to life. I misfired. I'm sorry, Tyron. I misfired. I literally shot the sniper bullet, and then Ice Ghost went like this, and you were right behind him, and you were like, ugh. Oh, black holes. I don't like black holes, bro. Yo, I'm scared of outer space. Don't show me that shit. Outer space is scary as hell. This game reminds me of Journey for the PlayStation. The aesthetic of this game is literally Journey for the PlayStation 4. I want this game. This game looks so cool. You said it looks like indie dev graphics? Definitely. It reminded me instantly of Journey. I love that game. Aaron James said, I'd smash.
It was always gonna end like this.
Everyone's saying Hitman. I was thinking Hitman as well, not gonna lie. I was like, this kind of looks like Hitman.
All your sacrifice only sped up the process.
Got binked.
And now
you got binked.
You find yourself alone.
This is loud. You got binked. Karen!
Only death awaits.
Hitman 3. Hitman 3.
Hakan Abrak here from IO Interactive. In Hitman 3,
Agent 47 is back for his most intimate and professional contract in his entire career. This is also the dramatic conclusion for the World of Assassination trilogy. I'm so proud to be here to present a little glimpse of the gameplay where Agent 47 is on top of the world in Dubai.
So this is the conclusion of the other games? Damn it, now I have to play the other games. Not the last Hitman, it's the conclusion of the other two Hitmans. Death awaits in January 2021. Don't say that. Now I'm scared. What if we don't even make it to 2021? What if we actually die in 2021? The UI! It's the UI! It's the UI! Why do I feel like I'll like this game? I think I'm gonna like this game. Astro Playroom? It's a Japan studio game, bro. Those guys make Patapon. You notice each one of those transitions is showing us more and more of the PlayStation 5 each time it transitions. Ooh, I like the art style of this game. What the heck are those? Something about this game, I like the aesthetic a lot. It looks really nice. What is that guy? Is he in his stomach? Is he supposed to be playing as a white blood cell? Little devil inside? So maybe...
What's up, everyone? I'm Zion Williams to the New Orleans Pelicans. Here we go. The first ever teaser for NBA 2K21. Y'all are not ready for this.
Sports simulation? Sports simulator?
trying to bring you down, but for real, you might as well give up now. Think you got a chance, but I don't see how. Got a real tight grip when I hold that crown. I'm the first one in and the last one out. Whoever owns the place gotta drag me out. I don't make a sound when I stray. You better just run for your life. Run for your life. Run for your life.
You broke the rim! What about everybody else that wants to play basketball? Why would you do that? Why would you do that? He broke it.
Amazing, aren't they? Half bug, half snack. A very recently discovered species, entirely unique to this island. Oh, this one's lively. Beautiful seed patterns. Oh, and it's tasty too. Welcome to the island of bug snacks.
Like a bug and kind of snack. Try to catch and then you'll trap. Feed somebody and you'll see me or whatever we eat.
Awesome.
Find them hiding in the sand. Tearing up a ketchup patch. Come to Snaptooth Island and discover
it's
bug snacks. It's bug snacks. Talking about bug snacks. It's bug snacks.
Is the platinum trophy easy to get? That's all I'm asking.
My invitation is open. Come join me on the island of Bugsnacks.
Liz! I was trying to carry a lamp with my weenie hands, but I dropped it, and now the town's on fire.
Oh, again?
Bugsnacks.
The song was nice, and if this game is an easy platinum, I'll play it. But if this game got dumb platinums like you gotta eat all the food on the island 100,000 times, I'm not playing it. We got the bad ending. What the hell? Are we seeing the console now?
Hi everyone, thank you for being with us today for this very special event. But before we get to the end of the show, I have something very near and dear to me.
This was a whole E3 presentation. Oh my gosh. What is this, Dark Souls? This looks like some Dark Souls shit. What the heck? That thing is huge. Diablo? Demon Souls. The chat was Demon Souls. What? That shit looks crazy. That shit looks crazy. I don't know how the hell we're gonna fight that.
Deathloop is a next-gen first-person shooter about rival assassins locked in a time loop.
What this is our unique vision, what Arkane is all about.
Freeform immersive gameplay, a surreal player-driven story smashed together.
Smash? Smash, brother, smash!
Making this easy.
What is this, BioShock? This looked like BioShock, son. And I never played BioShock. Oh my god, it's like super hot.
Good morning, Black Reef. Another day, another death.
Yo, Dishonor? You said this is Dishonor. I remember this game was very hyped up when it first came out, the other one.
For everyone else on this island, this place is paradise. A never-ending party. Where hunting me is the main attraction. And no matter how I try to escape, they always cut me down. But I'm one stubborn motherfucker.
Yo! You saw how he was swiping them? He was just throwing them. Yo, this is
every
clean.
Loop, I'm learning a little more, piecing together the puzzle. There's 8 targets, and they all gotta die before midnight. There's just one little snag.
You thought it was going to be easy?
Juliana Blake, Black Reef's protector, and a real pain in my ass. She may kill me a million times, but eventually, inevitably, I will break this fucking loop.
Yo, this game looks fire, man. Yo, so when you die, you gotta rewind? And then it shows you rewinding everything. That's so cool. So the game's called Deathloop.
I don't like watching you die. I like killing you. There's a difference.
Oh, she don't like watching you die. She like killing you. Uh-oh. It was shaping. The square was shaping it up. His story comes to a close.
Long Who? Ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father. It was hard at work.
Determined to find the berries, the rascal broke free of Mother's grasp and
Hold
vanished
on.
Into the trees.
She's talking super low.
Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine, under branch, and into the forest deep.
What is it with that creepy story?
It's just a local tale.
You're really into that stuff?
Quit being so paranoid.
No, no! Friendly! Friendly! Who are you? Who sent you?
What's going on?
They're coming. Who is?
Is this another Resident Evil game, bro? This shit look like Resident Evil 4. I better hear Te Voy a Matar. Was that the horse? That was the horse. This gotta be Resident Evil. The ogre! It's the ogre from... Oh! Village? Yo, Sony won, bro. Bro. Oh my. Oh, it's shaping. The system is shaping, bro. It's the shape shaping.
It's the fucking shapes.
What the fuck is this? Why is he in New York City? He in 42nd Street. Is this Kojima? What the hell? This dude is huge compared to her. Is that a satellite, my guy? The satellite? How? What? 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 What is this, Danganronpa? My man, let me not even talk about it, cause I already said too much.
What is that?
Freedom, our freedom.
It's like you saw how they just broke out, like they just broke out the shits.
Thank you.
Uh-oh, it's flattening out. It's flattening out. Yo, this whole presentation is just my balls being tickled. And then they stop. And then they keep tickling my shit. And then they stop. What the hell? Yo, Tarzan the video game, please.
The old ones perished 1,000 years ago. They're great cities.
Was that a giant thing? Graves. That should look like almost like the giant robots.
In their place came new life.
Horizon Zero Dawn 2? Bro, no way!
I must find a way no to way. Stop it. Or we'll get worse and worse.
No way! It's a giant mechanical turtle!
Nothing I wouldn't do to save this world.
They really did a Horizon 2. I still got part 1 and I haven't touched it. I have to play part 1 and I have the definitive edition.
No secret I won't unlock.
Yo.
No barrier. I won't cross. This mission is mine alone. If I falter, if I fail, there won't be anyone left to stop what's coming.
Forbidden West. Horizon 2, Forbidden West.
But whatever comes.
They got psychopathic elephants.
I will be ready.
Guerrilla Gaming, bro. Those are the guys that made Killzone. Yo.
On behalf of the entire team at Guerrilla, we're happy to share the first look at Horizon Forbidden West.
We're continuing Ellie's story as she moves west to a far future America.
To brave a beautiful but dangerous frontier, masked with mysterious new threats.
Yo.
Get ready to explore distant lands ravaged by massive storms.
And take on new, powerful machines as you return
to the majestic world of Horizon.
Stay tuned for much more. We can't wait for you to get your hands on it.
Yo. You said Chad Warden is smiling.
I think there's a lot to look forward to for the community.
I think fans are going to be really pleased.
As a game designer and storyteller, this is incredibly exciting. We're talking a whole new generation of ideas and experiences that we can create for the player.
No matter where they are, no matter who they are.
New experiences like we've never had before.
More iconic, interesting characters. More atmospheric, immersive worlds for players to explore.
We want to wow players.
Expect the unexpected.
And I, for one, can't wait.
You can't wait.
We can't wait to share them with you.
It's so exciting.
Incredibly exciting.
It's really about...
They're about to show the console.
As a developer, that's an amazing feeling to have.
Welcome to PlayStation 5.
Oh, God. They're gonna show the console. They have to show the console. You can't tickle my balls any longer. And it's actually balls. It's a game sphere! Bro. Bro. It's a tower? Don't tell me it's a tower as well. It's gonna be a tower. No, it's not. It's merging out. It's battle against the towers. What? You saw the two lights? Oh baby, it's time. Bro. This shit looking weird. Hold up. Okay. It's looking slick. You see, look. They put some thought into this. Xbox took the freaking easy route. They were like, let's just make a box. Look at this design. Look at the slick. This look like this is the future. Look at this design. This is, bro. Bro, PS5, baby. It's over. This shit to me, honestly, it's new. It looks good. You said a dildo? It's unique. So that's where the Heat fans are and everything. Give me some more close-ups. USB, okay. PS5 digital edition. No, I want mine. I want my original PS5. I want to put my stuff in it. There's a digital only additional. Oh my God. All digital. HD camera. Pulse 3D headphones. Okay. Media remote. Okay. Give me a price. I don't care if I have to sell my left.
I hope you've enjoyed the first glimpse of our future today.
Bro.
You've seen our most striking console design yet. And you've seen games that can only be enjoyed with the full range of PlayStation 5's features and power. At PlayStation, we believe in generational transitions, and we put years of work into making them happen.
They're smart.
We want you to enjoy the unique benefits.
They made two versions of it already.
Of moving from one generation to the next.
They got the all digital, which is going to be cheaper, probably.
We're launching later this year, and we have tons more to share. Welcome to PlayStation 5.
Yo. Yo, the design, bro. I like it. I'm liking it. Bro. You said, can't you buy digitally on the original? Yes. But I guess what they're saying is, in the all digital version, you cannot put physical CDs inside. But on the other version, you could actually put CDs, look, right there, because it has a CD slot. The all digital version, I feel like might be slightly cheaper, but I actually want to get my physical CDs. Bro. said it looks like a Wi-Fi adapter. I'm gonna be real with you. That's the most accurate representation I could say about the PlayStation, the PlayStation 5. That shit, yo, it kind of does look like a Wi-Fi, a router. But one thing is for sure, at least it looks unique. That's what I'm gonna say. Because look, Xbox took the safest route they could possibly take. They made it a straight rectangle. They made it a rectangle and they were like, let's just make it a box. Let's make it a UPS box. I don't care. Just, they got girl Ratchet, bro. The price. We gotta know the price. What's the price? PlayStation. Oh God, they're not gonna tell us the price. They gonna wait to tell us the price like some other time on the next. Okay, at least we got to see the console. At least we got to see the console. That's all that matters. I feel like this was a solid, very strong, good ass. Yo, if this was at E3, man, I think everyone would have been like, Sony won. 700? Bro, if it's $700 to $1,000, bro, I'm gonna have to work some overtime at my job, bro. I'm paying for that. I'm paying for that. No cap. I'm going to pay for that. Balloon Boy said, I don't think so. I'm paying for that. You say you want the price? You know what? Everyone in the chat saying I want the price. Here's the thing. You might as well start saving up now. Because that shit, we still got a while to go before that shit releases. And best believe, I'm going to have my credit card ready with the three-digit code on the back. I'm going to have that shit on standby like this. Whew. I'd buy for $600. You said, I want the release date. The release date, obviously, is going to most likely be around holiday season to early or first quarter next year. Holiday season or first quarter next year. I mean, if they do miss the holiday season, they know damn well like they can't really miss out on the holiday season for selling the PlayStation 5 because that's where they make most of the money. If that shit does release at that time, man, they're gonna do a lot of sales. If this shit is $700 and still sounds like a fucking jet engine like the PS4, bro. You better have an AC in your room then. You said they're making three versions, by the way. 500 gig. No. 500 gig. Oh, you see, look, they didn't say that. Why? Why, bro? 500 gigs? You know how little that is? I have a PlayStation with 500 gigs. I'm going to have to get the 2 terabyte version. But, yo, that's just going to be like $1,000. I'm going to have to get the 2 terabyte model. Because then here's the thing, too. If you take into consideration, Sony is making hard drives that's, like, very exclusive to them. It's not like hard drives that you could just go, like you could go on Amazon and let me get a Western Digital hard drive. No, it has to be, like, the Sony